another podcast from Gerber & Company. Visit our website at www.gerberco.com for a treasure chest of useful financial and tax planning ideas. It now gives us great pleasure to present Glenn Broder to you. Glenn will be teaching us about advanced marketing, promotional, sales, and closing technologies in a system that works. You'll be able to sell, persuade, convince, and close more effectively when you paid attention to what Glenn does. He's a superstar in his field, and it's an honor for us to welcome him here to Gerber & Company. Thank you, Glenn.
Thank you very much, Selwyn. I appreciate the introduction. I've put together a structured selling system, which I call just a yes or no please. And what a structured selling system is, and the easiest way to describe it is to tell you my first experience with it. When I first started in sales, I've now been in a career of closing business for 25 years. The first presentation I learned was 39 pages long, and I had to do it word for word. And what we learned in this presentation were five secrets to closing business on a predictable basis. And those are the five secrets that I'd like to share with everybody today. Now, in closing business, we were taught immediately that there are some major points that you have to consider in sales. And those are the five secrets. The first is what we call mirroring. Now, what mirroring is a simple way to build immediate rapport with anybody you meet for the first time. Now, people say, wow, that sounds like a tall order. How can you do that predictably? Well, rapport building, psychologically, the quickest way to do it is to mirror the actions of the person you are meeting. If he leans back, you lean back. If he scratches his ear, you scratch your ear. If he sits in a certain way, you sit exactly that same way. And what will happen psychologically and subconsciously, without them realizing it's going on, is you will build immediate rapport. That would be the first major point. The second is modeling. Now, what is modeling? If one person can do anything, others can learn to do the same thing. It's the quickest way to learn to do anything. And as related to sales and business and closing business, it's the perfect way to train yourself to be as polished as possible. Now, in modeling, companies that I do consulting with all have the same profile. You always have several stars, maybe one or two. You have a big group of mediocre, and then you have a group at the bottom that really is there on the whim of the company, but they probably shouldn't be all that involved. The group that we look to affect the most is the mediocre. And the way that we affect the mediocre is by showing them the details of what the stars do. So I don't come in and do a workshop where I tell you, here's some great new idea of doing this. I facilitate using your stars and your experts to show the mediocre what they're missing and why they're missing deals to the competition. So immediately, if we can show them some of the tricks and some of the diligent points where the stars are truly effective, they can draw up their closing percentages. So you have mirroring and modeling. The next three, I'm going to tell you what they are first and then show you how all five actually intertwine in my system. And remember, my system is one where we can literally plug in any product or service into three parts of my structured 12-step system You fill in the details of your product or service in these three spots, and we can literally present anything. I've done from home improvements and blue collar sales up to the highest technology and patent sales. And everything in between, diamond companies, programming companies, security companies, it makes absolutely no difference. The setup's only difference is your specific information. So the last three secrets, secret number three, is called visual motor rehearsal. Secret number four is called neuro-linguistic programming. And the biggest secret of all, questioning to clarity. Now, what are these three things? First is visual motor rehearsal. And visual motor rehearsal says that the mind and the brain does not know the difference between the practical and the practice. Now, what does that mean? And how does it relate to sales? Okay, it's very, very simple. What it says is if you are so polished that you can visualize an experience, your body won't know the difference between whether you're practicing it or actually practically doing it. And you'll say, Glenn, now you're getting into some things that really sound a little bit crazy. However, since the invention of the MRI, we can now watch brain chemicals as they're reacting in the brain at any given time. So we know certain stimuli just automatically make certain brains light up in certain ways. So what visual motor rehearsal says is if you visualize and practice, you will become natural at presenting or projecting what you want to project. So how did they prove it? They proved it with world-class athletes, Olympic athletes to be exact. The first program was developed by NASA, but then they, in the 80s, decided they were going to apply it to world-class athletes in the Olympics. Now you can imagine, if you run a race 50 times a day, coming out of the blocks exactly the same, making your first surge exactly the same, everything step by step exactly the same, their times are so close over and over, that kind of a person is the best visualizer. He would be the person that you could point to use as an example. So what did they do? They hooked these world-class athletes up to electronic sensing machine, every muscle in their body. They sat them in a chair and they said, visualize a race from start to finish, that 10 seconds of the 40-yard dash or the 100-yard dash, whatever the distance was, and don't move. Run it in your mind. And you want to know what? The brain cannot tell the difference between practice and practical. So implying that the business, it says, the guy who's flying by the seat of his pants is not going to succeed. The guy who's diligent in everything every time is going to be projecting the greatest confidence. So that's visual motor rehearsal. Neuro-linguistic programming. What that basically says is what you put in is what you get out. You need to be very careful with how you educate yourself in becoming polished so that you can do it naturally. And then finally, the biggest secret of all, questioning the clarity. I have put together a system that was described to me by my father. He said the best way to know anything about what other people are thinking is to ask them. Don't guess. Question to clarity. And the residual effect from questioning to clarity in a sales and a business relationship is that the prospect has closed themselves. At the end, it's just a matter of taking their words and now showing them they already made the decision. Now we just need to move to action.